I'm here at EsNews Boxing talking to boxing trainer Brandon Krause. Break it down. Andre Ward.
I mean, he
Edwin
just looks,
Rodriguez.
He looks spectacular. You know, HBO was really fishing for any opponent to put in front of him. And Edwin Rodriguez, Edwin Rodriguez didn't prove to really be much of competition to Andre, but it was a good showcase in case you forgot how beautiful of a boxer this guy Andre is. And what I really like is yeah, he is gorgeous and beautiful to watch, but he's also a mean son of a bitch that really goes after guys and tries to inflict damage on them, and that's what I like. Couldn't get the KO, but definitely controlled every bit of the fight. And the question is, what's next? You know, you've cleaned out 168. There's no one for you to make money with. There's nobody to challenge you. And then at 175, there's nothing but big punchers that honestly, on any given night, you know, can land one of those shots. And who knows, the shot coming from a Konolev or a Stevenson at 175 may feel a little bit different than these big punchers at 168. Or you may very well go on to be quite successful at 175 also. But it seems like the only option left for Andre is to move up and wait, and it'll be fun to see what materializes from it.
It was a good fight. It was very entertaining to watch. I don't know why people complain about Andre Ward's fight.
You know, I don't know why people complain about any two guys duking it out for their livelihood in front of an audience, but Jackie Reese sure took control, and you don't see that very often. 2-point deduction on either side, you know, putting them each in line to be DQ'd if shit starts going really bad. And it seemed to make the fight go better. I've been hearing clamor like Edwin Rodriguez was trying to get DQ'd. No, I think he was just trying to make it a rough and tough fight, and he went a little too far. But it turned out to be entertaining from my standpoint.
I enjoyed it. It was a good performance. I was impressed with, of course, with Ward's and his skills. But also, you got to give Edwin Rodriguez credit for his chin.
Yeah, you know, Andre Ward isn't a vicious one-punch guy. He's like kind of that calculated assassin that has to set a perfect trap for you. And he did land his money punch left hook a number of times, and Rodriguez seemed to take it well. And, you know, you don't watch Andre Ward to see guys flat on the canvas. You watch it to see a mastery of skill of boxing.
And there we saw. Let's see if Triple G is next or Chavez Jr. Which one would you want if it was up to you?
Out of those two, I would prefer Triple G.
Who wins that one?
Andre Ward.
You heard it here. Brandon Krause, EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Alicia Beck reporting.